Ladies and gentlemen, yesterday a first pre-release for Minecraft 1.18.2 was released with lots of improvements for custom world data packs. My name is SlySlam, apologies for being slightly late with this video, but of course I am here to guide you through all the changes in this pre-release. Before we get into the changes, let me also mention another piece of news announced together with this pre-release. The expected release date of Minecraft 1.18.2 is the 28th of February. Let's start with the changes in gameplay. A bug has been fixed that made you sometimes not jump diagonally when jumping up a diagonal corner. In mob news, a change has been made to dolphins, allowing them to be more accurate in finding the closest structure when you feed them fish. Speaking of structures, a number of structure-related bugs have also been fixed. Structures in superflat worlds will now spawn the appropriate structure-specific mobs. In user interface news, players playing on 32-bit computers or using 32-bit Java executables will now get a warning that the 32-bit support for the game will be removed in some upcoming version of the game. A single visual fix in this version makes fireworks particles spawn on the correct hand when flying with fireworks and holding firework rockets in both hands. In server news, the server.properties file generated by the game now contains some settings that were previously missing, including level seed, level type, generator settings, and generate structures. The rest of the changes in this version are all technical stuff concerning data packs. We're going to deep dive right into that, but let me first ask you to use the like button function for the video. That makes YouTube show the video to more viewers, so I'd really appreciate it. Thank you. Now to begin with, the current data pack version is now 9. In order to have a data pack not flagged as out of date, you'll need to update the pack.mc meta file. In command-related news, the locate command now has a different type of parameter. Instead of a built-in structure type, it now wants a configured structure type. These are in some cases the same, but in other cases more precise. For instance, instead of locating a village, you'll now be locating a village underscore plains, in specific. If you still want to locate any village, you can use another new piece of functionality where the locate and locate biome commands now both support tags as an argument. So, to locate any type of village, you now instead use locate hash village. Configure structure tags are available for all cases where more than one configure structure exists per built-in structure type. So, to upgrade a previously existing command, you'll simply need to add a hash sign. Speaking of tags, there are now new tags for configured structures. These include all the ones I just mentioned for mineshafts, ocean ruins, ruined portals, shipwrecks, and villages. But there are also ones that control some aspect of gameplay. Let's start with Dolphin Located, controlling which types of structures a dolphin can locate when fed fish. Eye of Ender Located is similar, it controls what type of structure an eye will travel towards when thrown. There are also three tags related to maps, on treasure maps, on ocean explorer maps, and on woodland explorer maps, controlling which types of structures that type of map points to. A predicate change. The feature field in location predicates now also reference configured structures rather than built-in structure types. And for loot tables, the same thing applies to the destination field of an exploration map loot table function. The exploration map function also no longer automatically sets the name of the item, so you'll need to do that with a separate set name function instead. Now let's get into custom worlds. It is now possible to add custom structures to the game. This is done by adding a new type of configured feature, and then a new structure set. Structure sets are a new type of file found under the worldgen/structure_set folder, and contain a set of structures and how they are placed. The placement is exactly the type of placement that would previously be specified inside of the noise settings for a dimension. The set of structures is a weighted list of configured structures. When placing structures, the game will randomize the order according to the weights and then place the first one that matches the biome requirement. This also means that those structure placement settings are no longer present in the noise settings files. There are also new capabilities in the configured structures themselves. They now have a spawn overrides field. This can contain sections for each spawn category pointing to a spawn override for that spawn category. Each override contains a definition of which type of bounding box it covers, either full, applying when spawning in the bounding box of the entire structure, or piece, applying when spawning in the bounding box of any structure piece. The overrides also contain a weighted list of entity types to spawn, with min and max counts for each type. This is exactly the same type of data that is specified for spawns in a biome file. The configured structure files also have a new optional Boolean field named AdaptNoise. When this is set to true, the game will attempt to adapt the surrounding terrain to make the structure fit in. An example of where this is used in a vanilla game is for villages. The other big piece of custom world news in this version is called density functions and the noise router. Density functions are a new type of file found under worldgen/density_function and defines a way to calculate a density based on other such density functions and noise values from the world. In particular, cave generation works by combining such density functions together, which is done by a new system called the noise router. Density functions can be specified in their own files or also directly in the noise router fields inside the noise settings file for a dimension. There are a number of fields in the noise router settings that all define different ways the game computes different densities in the process of generating the world. To explore these further, take a look at the way they are used and specified in the vanilla world generation files. There are a huge number of different density function types available. The simplest type is a constant that just provides the same value everywhere. And as a special case, constant value density functions can be written as just the number. Then there are a number of functions that source data from the world into calculations and don't take any arguments at all. These are old blended noise, end islands, blend offset, and blend alpha. Another source is the noise type. It has three parameters, a noise parameter, and XC scale and Y scale values. There's also shifted noise, which also has those same three parameters. Shifted noises then also have three density function arguments called shiftX, shiftY, and shiftZ. One more type of source is called the Y-clamped gradient type. It provides a value only depending on the height in the world. Fields for this type are from Y, to Y, from value, and to value, all numbers. A number of function types take one density function input and applies an operation on the result of that function. These all have one single field called argument that contains that density function. The types of these functions are interpolated, abs, shift A, shift B, blend density, slide, square, cube, half negative, quarter negative, and squeeze. A number of functions for improving the efficiency of calculations by caching also only take a source density function argument. They are flat cache, cache2d, cache once, and cache all in cell. There are four function types that take two arguments and apply an operation. They are add, mul, min, and max. The remaining function types all have a special set of parameters. Weird scaled sampler has three parameters. Input, which is another density function, noise, which references a noise file in worldgen/noise, and rarity value mapper, which is type 1 or type 2. Range choice chooses a density function to use as the output, depending on if the input density function evaluates to within or outside a specified range. It has input, when in range and when out of range arguments that specify density functions, and min inclusive and max exclusive values to define the range. The clamp function type takes a density function input and clamps it to a range specified by min and max values. There's also the terrain shaper spline function type that has continentalness, erosion, and weirdness density function inputs, as well as a spline string field and min value and max value values. There are also two density functions that are currently unused by vanilla files, beardifier and shift. Let's wrap up with one known issue in this pre-release. Some superflat presets do not work at all, and you will instead get an error when trying to create such a world. That's all for this time. Thank you for taking the noise route with me all the way to the end of the video, I really appreciate it. If you also want to know what is coming in the wild update, here's another great video for you.